Welcome back. We are on the topic percentages. In the previous video, we learned how to calculate compound interest. In this video, we are going to solve a practical problem involving compound interest. The problem is, Alaba deposits an amount of 5,000 Ghana cedis at a bank. The rate of interest was 5% per annum for 2 years. Calculate I, the simple interest, and II, the compound interest, and. So the amount of money Alaba deposits in her account is the same as the principal. So here the principal is 5,000 Ghana cedis. The rate of interest was 5% per annum and the period is 2 years. The question wants us to first calculate for the simple interest at the end of the 2 year period. Then we calculate for the compound interest at the end of the 2 year period. So let's start with the first one, the simple interest. We know that simple interest is equal to principal times rate times time divided by 100. The principal is 5,000 Ghana cedis, the rate is 5%, and the time is 2 years. The rate in the formula here is already a percentage. So the simple interest is equal to the principal, which is 5,000, times the rate. Because it's already a percentage, the rate is 5 times the time, which is 2, divided by 100. Now this will give us 500 Ghana cedis. So if you simplify this, you are going to have 500 Ghana cedis. This means that the simple interest earned at the end of the 2 years was 500 Ghana cedis. The second part of the question says that we should calculate for the compound interest. Once again, the principal is 5,000 Ghana cedis, the time is 2 years, and the rate is 5%. So at the end of the first year, Alaba's interest is equal to 5% of the principal. So the principal is 5,000 Ghana cedis. So 5% of 5,000 Ghana cedis is the same as 5 divided by 100 times 5,000 Ghana cedis. And this will give us 250 Ghana cedis. So at the end of the first year, the interest on the principal is 250 Ghana cedis. This means that the principal after the first year, that is the new principal, or the amount of money in his account after the first year, is going to be the initial principal, which is 5,000 Ghana cedis, plus the interest on the principal, which is 250 Ghana cedis. So after the first year, the new principal is 5,250 Ghana cedis. So this is the amount of money Alaba has in her account at the end of the first year. Now, let's calculate for the interest after the second year, or at the end of the second year. We know that the principal after the first year is 5,250 Ghana cedis. And because we are calculating for compound interest, we are going to use this new principal. So the interest at the end of the second year is 5% of the principal because the rate is 5%. But this time, the principal is this new principal that we have here, which is 5,250 Ghana cedis. So the interest at the end of the second year is equal to 5 divided by 100 times 5,250 Ghana cedis. And this will give us 262 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos. So the interest at the end of the second year is 262 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos. Now, the amount of money Alaba has at the end of the second year is equal to the principal, which is 5,250 Ghana cedis, plus the interest at the end of the year. So at the start of the year, the principal was 5,250 Ghana cedis. And this principal earned an interest of 262 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos. So if you add these two, you are going to get the amount of money in Alaba's account at the end of the second year. When we add these two, you have 5,512 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos. So at the end of the 2 year period, Alaba had 5,512 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos in her account. The amount she deposited was 5,000 Ghana cedis. That means that the interest is equal to the amount at the end of the second year. That is the amount in her account at the end of the second year minus the amount she deposited. So this will give us 5,512 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos, minus the amount she deposited, which is 5,000 Ghana cedis. When we do this, we are going to have 512 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos. This means that the compound interest Alaba earned at the end of the 2 year period was 512 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos. When we calculated for simple interest, we had 500 Ghana cedis. But for compound interest, we are having 512 Ghana cedis, 50 pesos. The reason is that for simple interest, the principal remains constant throughout the 2 year period. But for compound interest, the principal keeps on increasing. So the compound interest at the end of the 2 year period will be higher than the simple interest at the end of the 2 year period. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe to this channel for more videos. In the next video, we are going to solve another practical problem involving compound interest. Bye-bye.